So this is an interesting story simply because it's both old news and about something that hasn't actually happened yet. There was a series of stories that I saw that were released around a week ago that were talking about Rotten Tomatoes' plan to block hate speech when it comes to the Black Panther movie that's coming out. And, you know, a bunch of people, I saw comments under the articles and whatnot, where people were like, well, maybe they just don't like the movie or whatever. And I kind of wonder if they actually read the article at all, or they just saw the headline, you know, oh, they're banning people from giving a bad review to a movie about Black people, and then just decided the rest from there. See, one of the important things to keep in mind here is that Black Panther hasn't released yet, as of the time I'm recording this anyway. Maybe it goes up after Black Panther is released. But I'm recording this on the 12th, and it's going up on the 16th, I believe. And there's the other side to this story, the side where this is already a week old, and it's talking about plans that have been announced on the internet, including multiple Facebook groups, although I could only find one, but purportedly multiple Facebook groups who have set dates to go after this movie the day it comes out, to review bomb a movie that they couldn't possibly have seen at the time, because at the time that these started becoming publicly known, there hadn't even been press screenings yet. There's literally no way that they could have formed an opinion on the movie itself. What you have here is a bunch of people with one political goal for disparate reasons. They want to tank the movie for reasons from things as trivial as fanboy wars. The DC fanboys who are upset that Marvel gets better scores than DC want to tank this movie simply for that. To white supremacy. There are people who are angry that a movie is predominantly Black and therefore is automatically racist. Whereas a movie that's predominantly white is... I don't even know. I can't help you here. And while there are DC fans in the mix looking to strike back out at people because what they like isn't popular, ignoring the fact that when they make a movie that doesn't suck, like Wonder Woman, it actually gets good reviews both from the fans and from the press, there seems to be a large element of pushback against perceived progressivism. The basic idea being the horror that there's something out there that is massively popular, that's setting trends in terms of box offices, and it's not aimed specifically at me. You know, like Nickelback only possibly could. And I say possibly because there is still a possibility that I'm not going to like this movie. I think the chances are pretty remote because based on the teasers that we've gotten, it looks like it's exciting and at least going to hold my interest. But I've been wrong before and I know that, so I'm not going to say, oh my god, this movie is awesome before I've seen it. And it's kind of screwed up that I even need to say that because really, not judging something you haven't seen for content that you don't know exists in it should probably be something that is, you know, standard. But that's kind of a recurring problem, isn't it? Before Mad Max hit theaters, people were outraged by it. Before Ghostbusters even had a single screenshot or a casting announcement or anything other than the fact that women were going to star in it, there was a massive backlash. Hell, it didn't even actually take a female doctor being cast to cause an uproar with Doctor Who fans. It took the mere suggestion sometime back before David Tennant, and there's probably been backlash before this too. I know that they tossed around the idea of a female doctor in the 80s, according to Tom Baker, and possibly some other people on the show. And now that we've actually had a female doctor appear and say all of two words on TV, we're being told that this is the worst run in the history of Doctor Who, which is absolutely ridiculous if you've ever watched Doctor Who. But it's also ridiculous from a prejudicial standpoint because we've got almost nothing to go on. And that's the thing. It sort of makes me wonder what the end game is here. Because from my outsider perspective, this looks like you're poisoning your own well. Poisoning the well is something you're supposed to do to other people. You're not supposed to give people a reason to adversely look upon you, to prejudice them against your views. But that's exactly what happens when you decide that a movie is going to be bad or you're going to destroy it because it's got a Black lead or because there's a woman in a traditionally male part or whatever other thing that's going to happen. And especially if there is a critical response but a commercial success where people hate it, even if it's just a small concerted group, They're going to be written off as internet trolls, racist, angry basement dwellers, or whatever other buzzwords can be thrown around. I mean, not that I particularly mind if these people set themselves up to fail. I'm just wondering what could possibly be the mindset involved here. Thanks for listening. Amaranth out.